What is the CARES Act? The CARES Act, or Coronavirus Aid, Relief, and Economic Security Act, was signed into law on March 27, 2020. It allocated $2.2 trillion to address various individuals and organizations impacted by COVID-19. Approximately $11.3 billion was allocated to Utah. Of that $11.3 billion, Utah received $1.25 billion of Coronavirus Relief Fund funds. 45%, or $562 million, of the CRF funds were allocated to be distributed to Utah local governments. How can CARES Act funds be used by local governments? The CARES Act requires that the payments from the Coronavirus Relief Fund only be used for expenses that are necessary expenditures incurred due to the public health emergency with respect to COVID-19, were not accounted for in the budget most recently approved as of March 27, 2020, the date of enactment of the CARES Act for the state or government, and were incurred during the period that begins on March 1, 2020 and ends on December 31, 2021. Per the U.S. Treasury, allowable expenses include medical, public health, and payroll for employees dedicated to COVID-19 management, compliance costs, and economic support. For example, an eligible use includes expenses for acquisition and distribution of medical supplies for public safety and health workers in connection with COVID-19. Another example of an eligible use includes the provision of grants to small businesses to reimburse the costs of business interruptions caused by required closures. When considering eligible uses, remember that documentation is critical. Two cities making identical eligible purchases, with one documenting that the purchase was necessary because of the public health emergency, and the other not having that documentation, should result in a finding and questioned cost for the entity that did not document, while the entity with the documentation would not have a finding. How can CARES Act funds not be used by local governments? Per the U.S. Treasury, uses cannot cover lost tax or other revenues, budget shortfalls, damages covered by insurance, payroll for employees not dedicated to COVID-19, severance pay, workforce bonuses, other than hazard pay or overtime, and legal settlements. For example, an ineligible use is allocating CARES Act funding to a percentage of all employees' compensation accounted for in a general fund. Another common mistake is allocating CARES Act funds to 100% of public safety salary and benefits to use up CARES Act funds. There is a difference in arguing that, due to a public health emergency, an entity implemented measures that caused the police to spend a certain percentage of each day implementing, facilitating, or enforcing processes related to the public health emergency. Thus, a certain percentage of police salaries and benefits is an eligible expense for CARES Act funding, as opposed to an entity having applied CARES Act funding to 100% of its police budget because it presumed that public safety in general was an eligible use. Another example of an ineligible use includes the purchase of equipment or facilities intended for economic development. The 2020 Compliance Supplement Addendum specifically requires that the acquisition itself must be necessary due to the COVID-19 public health emergency. In particular, a government must determine that it is not able to meet the need arising from the public health emergency in a cost-effective manner by leasing property or equipment, or by improving property already owned, and maintain documentation to support this determination. Following this guidance, a CPA firm testing CARES Act funds should request this documentation for any equipment or real property purchases. If the entity did not document why a lease was not used or failed to maintain that documentation, a finding should be issued. The final area of concern the office has observed is regarding grants to local businesses. Providing relief to local businesses is an allowable use of CARES Act funds. However, care should be taken regarding the controls placed over the grant process. In the course of an audit, if the controls over the grant process are weak and an error is found, the questioned cost may need to be the total expenditures of the grant program and not a specific grant. What is ARPA? ARPA, or the American Rescue Plan Act of 2021, was signed into law on March 11, 2021. It allocated $1.9 trillion to address various individuals and organizations impacted by COVID-19. Approximately $350 billion was allocated to state and local governments. Of that $350 billion, Utah local governments will receive $1.1 billion of Coronavirus State and Local Fiscal Recovery Funds, or SLFRF funds. How can ARPA funds be used by local governments? ARPA requires that the payments from ARPA funds only be used for expenses that support public health expenditures by, for example, funding COVID-19 mitigation efforts, medical expenses, behavioral health care, and certain public health and safety staff, address negative economic impacts caused by the public health emergency, including economic harms to workers, households, small businesses, impacted industries, and the public sector, replace lost public sector revenue, using this funding to provide government services to the extent of the reduction in revenue experienced due to the pandemic, provide premium pay for essential workers, offering additional support to those who have or will bear the greatest health risks because of their service in critical infrastructure sectors, invest in water, sewer, and broadband infrastructure, making necessary investments to improve access to clean drinking water, support vital wastewater and stormwater infrastructure, and to expand access to broadband internet. For example, an eligible use includes replacing lost tax or other revenues. An entity is required to use the trend analysis methodology established in the U.S. Treasury's interim final rule to calculate what is considered lost revenues. Some items may be excluded from this lost revenue calculation, such as federal grants. Do note that the lost revenues need to be demonstrated entity-wide, not simply within individual accounting funds. Once a shortfall is identified, entities will have broad latitude to use ARPA funds to support government services, up to the amount of lost revenue. Another example of an eligible use includes constructing or expanding broadband internet infrastructure in areas that are unserved or underserved, or lacking a wireline connection that reliably delivers minimum speeds of 25 megabits per second download and 3 megabits per second upload. How can ARPA funds not be used by local governments? Per the U.S. Treasury, ineligible uses include directly or indirectly offsetting a reduction in net tax revenue due to a change in law from March 3, 2021, through the last day of the fiscal year in which the funds provided have been spent, deposits to pension funds, debt service, legal settlements or judgments, deposits to rainy day funds or financial reserves, and general infrastructure spending, other than water, sewer, and broadband investments, or above the amount allocated under the revenue loss provision. For example, an ineligible use includes an entity reducing taxes and using ARPA funds to offset the tax reduction. The entity needs to demonstrate that tax cuts were paid from other sources other than ARPA funds, such as enacting policies to raise other revenues, reducing spending, or through higher revenue due to economic growth. Similar to CARES Act funds, ARPA funds require adequate documentation from the entities expending the funds. Governing bodies and staff should take a step back as they are planning how to use ARPA funds and ask themselves how far their logic is stretching to justify the proposed usage. In many situations, there are other expenditures that can easily qualify for these funding sources. The entity could also use other sources of revenue, such as property or sales tax, to accomplish its goals that may be considered a questionable use of ARPA funds.